ain't chilling either. Oh, is it quiet? I thought it was in my house,
and then was scary.
It was very scary, but it's outside in the little runway.
Ooh, stop.
Ooh, that was scary. I thought it was like a rat gonna come in here and run up on us. Or a skunk. We saw a skunk yesterday. She didn't believe me that there were skunks walking around here.
And then she stopped the car and was like, look, it's a skunk.
I put on my brights like, I told you, I could smell it.
We gotta be honest, it's gonna be long.
Oh, it does. Okay, yeah.
So
keep going.
Yeah, but it's just dealing with, it's just, when.
Why are you looking at me like that?
I'm just admiring your titties. Go ahead.
And I'm hungry is not over. That's fine.
Of gestation, of getting pregnant. I'm so fearful. I'm such a moody person in real life. I'd be having
maybe it'll level you out.
I think maybe some dick will level me out.
Okay, so we're gonna wrap this up.
But I do think, you know, sex in a committed in the context of a committed relationship releases certain hormones that will definitely level out my personality.
Oh, it's a great healthy thing when you're married. When I'm married.
Okay. And
you clap to do the,
so I can track the audio because I gotta sync it.
That's interesting.
Being in a happy committed relationship, it will definitely give me a certain level of like just refreshingness. I think you'll see it in my skin.
You're glowing.
That's Mac Gold Drops. I'm gonna have kids that are so much like me.
You're nervous?
No, I'm not, because I actually was a really good child, but I was not a difficult child.
I thought you said, you got whoopings until, you were just
like
talking
10.
About whoopings.
I got my last spanking when I was like 10.
Because you grabbed the belt.
I did grab the belt.
That's crazy. I was
but
so
my parents, scared of my mom. Emily, the thing was, my parents, like, I would get in trouble for dumb shit, like, talking, because, like, I knew everything. I've always over-talked people. You just laughed and you cut off my thought. Then I lose my thought.
You were talking about how talking over, and you would just, you knew everything.
Oh, yeah, I would get in trouble because I would interrupt. This is like I was a shiner.
Turn your light off.
It was right here, right?
Shining.
And I just, because I was like, y'all taking so long to figure this out. Like, this is so simple. I was that kid. Like, for real.
Oh, no.
Like, in kindergarten, in Mrs. Cleary's kindergarten class. We had half day of kindergarten when I was growing up. And we'd be like, what's the weather? And I would always want to tell it because I'm like, these dumb doorknobs in my classroom talking about, I don't know. And I'm like, look out the window. It's sunny. Duh. And I'm just like, why are we spending 15 minutes talking about the weather? Pick up the daggone sun, stick it on the chalkboard, say it's sunny. S is for sunny. Duh. And I was slick. My parents didn't have to be concerned about a whole lot because I definitely knew how to forge your signature. And not on, I wasn't forging
signature
on checks.
Though.
It would be like,
sorry, mommy.
On field trip slips or like after school programs, like theater. Like I was very kind of, I was big on books. And I grew up in a troublesome household, so we just had weird things that we couldn't do. And I was just like, for real? Like seriously? I can't take photography class? Like, come on, for real? And I lived in Delaware, so I wasn't. But I would get on the bus and like take the hour and a half ride to go 2 miles, because the bus system in Delaware is just on another level.
Wow! How old are you when
it.
You were doing this?
I was 12, 13.
Ooh, get ready, girl.
Like my FAFSA paperwork. I don't think my mother called me when my sister was in college. Like, how did you do this?
I'm just like, you were supposed to sign it. Oh, Tinder.
He said, "Hey, Bill, my kids are just gonna be slick." And bad. Not bad. They just gonna know everything. And that's like, I need to instill the fear.
You definitely need to instill the fear. I am a firm believer in fear. It worked for me, so. You should fear your parents at some level.
I feel.
Just like the Kermit.
I did
Kermit. Remember when we talked about the Kermit? You'd be like, oh. Roots.
Thanks
we
for watching.
We call it roots.
Why are we going to call it roots?
Because we've been talking about our roots.
I'm so hungry.
I'm I'm starving. I'm going to make you salmon.
Oh, you're making me salmon?
Yes, you didn't see that?
I did, but I didn't know if it was for me.
You thought I was just going to set out some salmon?
I still want Kayla to donate to the Itty Bitty Fluctuating Dish Medium Titty Committee.
Here.
Do you see this? Look at this.
No, I am not about to flash my boobies.
But you don't have to flash them, girl. They there. She just has... She's lying to me about her bra size. I think she's bigger than what she claims she is. I just want enough titty to cover my gut.
You have enough. Look at you. Have you lost weight?
No, I gained a lot of weight when I moved to D.C. I gained like 20 pounds.
Are you serious? Well, be ready. You know Houston. People like to eat in Houston.
They are skinny in Houston.
And I'm moving to Dallas. So hey, Dallas!
When she moves to Texas.
Oh, I'm so excited.
Maybe
so
we'll invite excited. You guys.
Maybe we will.
Do like a dinner party series.
Yes. Ooh, that would be really fun.
My brother's... This is so off topic.
Baby hair brigade. Oh my gosh. You know what? It's people were saying on that video, just accept your baby hair. I got dandruff. You see any dandruff? See
no, flakes? Look at these. Look at this. You see this? She got the Mashanti.
It's the way I was. Ah! I definitely have sideburns. I definitely do.
She got all this.
But I like my sideburns.
I think you could just get some eco styler.
Yeah, I just don't do that. Toothbrush. And it's unnecessary. It's unnecessary. But that'd be- You know who does that a lot? You love Megs because I think she's in Kelly. Do you know who that is?
I do.
Okay.
I think the color of our shirts look really nice in the camera.
Yes, they do.
Thanks for watching, loves. I hope you enjoyed it. Check out Julesy's next event in Brooklyn, October 4th. I'll be there. More information is below. Bye-bye.